everybody, and welcome to another video tutorial. Today we'll be upgrading the machine to use an all-metal hot end thanks to a couple mods that I designed myself, as well as installing the new Sierra Touch, which is Creality's BL Touch alternative. Full disclaimer, this is not a paid sponsorship. I was sent the Sierra Touch free of charge for testing purposes, and the opinions that you will see here are my own. Furthermore, undertake this at your own risk, and I'm in no way responsible if any damages may occur as a result. Before starting to design anything, I first needed to see how the hot end was mounted to the machine. So this meant disassembling the unit and seeing which portions could be reused and which ones needed to be changed. For the components that I'm building today, I did find it easier to do the test prints with PLA, so long as I monitored the temperatures. I then used my SLA printer to print with engineering materials. I went with the E3D V6 direct kit since even with the exchange rates it came to almost the same amount as a knockoff, and I knew the quality I was getting. Another benefit was the online resources that they provided to the user. They had diagrams which included important measurements and even had the steps for modifying the firmware. With all this information, I began designing the adapter for the hot end itself. Now in the stock version, the main cooling fan was attached to the outer case, which made the nozzle changes more difficult because of the lack of access. So I knew ahead of time that I would need to keep this area as clear as possible. What I ended up modeling was an adapter which fit into the stock gear section of the filament feed and used a zip tie to help ensure it remained in place. Although the zip tie wasn't necessary, it was an additional precaution to make sure everything held together. While the finished part was printing on the machine, I began making changes to the firmware. I changed the thermistor type to a number 5, which was the 100K thermistor ATC Sumitec 104 GT-2. With this portion change, it was now time to set the maximum temperature for the hot end. Because this was a higher temperature hot end, it was important to take into account how the firmware worked. For safety reasons, the firmware automatically reduces the max temperature reading by 15 degrees on the LCD screen. So to fully tighten the nozzle, we'll first have to increase the maximum temperature by this amount and lower it back down. With this hot end, the maximum temperature is 285 degrees Celsius. So if you do this, you'll want to make sure that you turn back down the maximum to 285 degrees after properly tightening the nozzle. I made a previous video showing how to do nozzle changes on this machine, which I'll link in the description below. By this point, I had already decided I would mount the cooling fan to the same screws as the Sierra Touch. Therefore, I modeled and began testing this portion together as soon as possible. With the mount for the Sierra Touch, there's a little bit of play involved. Therefore, it's important to keep this in mind when installing your part. In my first design, I created only one cooling fan. However, the parts weren't cooling properly in overhanging areas, so I redesigned this to a secondary output that ran on the other side of the nozzle. And although the designs don't necessarily match, they do, however, allow for minimal material use and more streamlined path for the airflow. At this point, I began installing the finalized parts that I had 3D printed and replacing the BL Touch with the CR Touch. One thing I noticed was that in my case, I had to use trial and error to manually set the Z offset of the machine. To do this, I'm going to level the bed by going to bed leveling. Afterwards, I went to prepare plus move axis, and I lowered the nozzle to the zero mark. Next, I went to control plus motion plus Z offset and began tweaking this value until I got a perfect first layer. This meant quite a few failed test prints, but was the best solution that I found given the issues I encountered.
Just make sure to save your settings, otherwise they won't be stored. So go back one menu after setting the Z offset and choose store settings.
For some reason, the nozzle would hit the bed whenever I used a proper method for calibration. The only difference was that I had compiled my own version of the firmware by using the source code which had been provided by Creality. In future, I would like to see them update the source code to reflect the changes which may have occurred, as well as updating Marlin to one of its more recent releases. Other than that, I didn't have any problems with the Sierra Touch. So I'm hoping that they've addressed the quality control issues which were present in the aftermarket BL Touch. Now, to make things easier for any of you who may wish to try this out for yourself, I'm making the files and the firmware available for download on my Thingiverse page. So would I say that the Sierra Touch hot end upgrade was worth it in the end? I would say that yes, depending on how you intend to use this machine. I'm personally swapping out materials fairly constantly, so not having to worry about bed leveling because of temperature changes makes the Sierra Touch worth it in my case. As for the hot end upgrade, well, that will depend on the materials that you intend to use. I do want to use some of my higher temperature materials, and I've been unable to utilize them because of limitations in my hot end. So once again, in my case, this does become relevant. Also, for those of you who actually want to use this video as a guide, keep in mind that I will be posting a transcript on my main website to make it easier to follow along. Alternatively, please feel free to slow down the video by hitting the gear icon on the bottom right hand corner of your screen to change the speed settings. If you want to support this channel, please feel free to check out some of the merch on my website. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.